Bona tarda, si us plau. Si són tan amables. Perquè si no comencem no podem acabar amb puntualitat també i ho hem de fer. Gràcies. Bueno, ara tenim una taula que posa de les pràctiques a la formació inicial a l'exercici docent, el cas de Finlàndia. Bueno, suposo que la major part de vostès també em coneixen a mi. Fa... què? Això? Hola, em senten o no? No? I ara? I ara me senten millor? Sí? Bé, doncs bueno, intentaré ser breu, jo també, no? Com els finlandesos, perquè és el que em diuen que a Finlàndia fan, no?, amb les taules. Bé, jo fa 22 anys que estic estudiant el sistema finlandès, més de 22. Vaig començar, 22 anys fa que vaig començar amb tota aquesta moguda. Jo no sóc professor universitari, com la major part de vostès, no? Sóc un psicòleg escolar que, com que fracassàvem a l'escola, vaig buscar opcions i alternatives, no? I l'any 91 es va publicar per primera vegada l'informe de la IEA sobre competència lectora, i quan jo vaig tenir accés a aquesta publicació, clar, em vaig donar compte molts dels alumnes que ens fracassen a Catalunya i a tot arreu, no? Però jo ho havia vist a la meva escola, tenien problemes de competència lectora. Clar, què feien a Finlàndia perquè van sortir els primers? I, bueno, a mi em van dir llavors els professors, i segurament és el fred, totes aquestes històries. Clar, si fos el fred, els professors suecs o els noruecs o els danesos no estarien amb les puntuacions que tenen. I aleshores vaig trucar a l'ambaixada de Finlàndia i vaig preguntar si hi havia algun finlandès a Barcelona, a Catalunya, no?, el que fos professor i que pogués parlar amb ell. I, bueno, doncs, em van dir que sí, hi havia una persona, però que no, fins que no donés permís no donaven el seu telèfon, no? Llavors em van donar el telèfon d'un senyor que es deia Pekka Tukkonen, que és aquest senyor que està aquí al costat meu. I fa 22 anys ens vam trobar una cita ciegas allò al Club Nòrdic, no? I, bueno, em va explicar per primera vegada què estava passant al seu país. Me'n recordo que vam estar gairebé 3 hores prenent un cafè i quan vaig acabar vaig pensar, aquest tio serà amic meu. Perquè és especial, no? I la veritat és que durant aquests 22, 23 anys, no?, hem tingut una amistat molt bonica, no? Ell és mestre finlandès, ara us presento així primer amb ell perquè el conec una mica més, no? Ell és mestre format a Helsinki, està casat amb una catalana, per això parla català i ens parlarà en català a tots. És una, jo diria, gràcies que avui estigui aquí. És una persona que ha donat classe aquí i ha donat classe allà. Llavors coneix els dos sistemes molt bé. I a més ara és director d'un col·legi. El col·legi que us posa aquí, no? Director del Sauna Kallio, no? De Järvenpää, no? Järvenpää està a 40 i escaig quilòmetres, no?, de Helsinki. D'allà és Sibelius, no?, si no recordo malament, el compositor de música, no? I, bueno, ell està a dintre del municipi aquest amb tot aquest procés que estàvem comentant aquest matí de la creació del currículum, no?, que ara estan els directors fent tot això. I, per tant, com aquest matí també hi havia algú que deia, ostres, seria interessant tenir una idea de, primer, què passen a les pràctiques, és a dir, que aquí estarà el Quimo, no?, que ens explicarà què fan, no?, però després també és interessant veure, quan ja estan formats, què passa amb aquests profes, no?, com s'organitzen, no?, i com d'alguna manera doncs van tirant els nanos endavant. I aleshores eren dues visions que eren, a mi em semblava interessants. El Pekka parla molts idiomes, parla 9 idiomes, encara que hi digui que no, però parla molts. Jo va haver una vegada que el vaig acompanyar en cotxe des de Barcelona, quan va marxar a Finlàndia, el vaig acompanyar en cotxe des de Barcelona fins a Helsinki, mentre la seva dona anava amb avió, no? I vam anar amb el cotxe tot carregat, com aquests que se'n van al Marroc, no? Doncs són tots així, carregats. I tots els països que passàvem, el tio s'entenava la llengua. I clar, jo deia, ostres, peca, que entens això? Ostres, peca, estem a Alemanya, tio, però com t'enteres d'això? I llavors entràvem a Dinamarca i sí, mira, Xavi, així passa aquí, això no, no veus, aquí no hem d'anar perquè passa no sé què. Hòstia, tio, però... Llavors creuàvem a Suècia, hòstia, el tio parlava suec. I el parlava. I clar, bueno, que... Això perquè veieu que el tipus de, m'explico, de persona que són molt humils, i això és una cosa que als finlandesos ens passa, que normalment, si, quan diuen, passes a parlar molt bé aquesta llengua, et diuen, bueno, més o menys, que cony, més o menys, la parlen bé, ja el veureu ara, amb ell. I gràcies per haver vingut, vale? És un plaer que avui puguis estar aquí. I per altre cantó tenim aquí doncs el Quimo, no? Que és director d'una escola de pràctiques de la Universitat de Helsinki, que és molt important, no? I clar, l'escola de pràctiques és com un laboratori. És com un, a la vegada és una escola i a la vegada és com un laboratori de recerca i innovació. I aquest disseny és extraordinari, no? I si el professorat està molt ben format, allà seleccionen encara molt més a la gent que és la que et dona les classes de pràctiques. És a dir, imagineu-vos el nivell de la gent d'aquestes escoles. Pues imagineu-vos el nivell del seu director. Vale? Per tant, és una persona extraordinària. Que a més té formació de música, no? És una persona amb una gran sensibilitat i doncs ara li explicava que aquí el nostre fantàstic ministre ha retallat hores de música, no? I a veure què fan allà, no? Bé, doncs jo me callo perquè, tot i que hi ha coses que vull dir més, crec que és important que els sentim amb ells, no? Que és el que hem vingut a fer. Llavors crec que ja us ho heu organitzat entre els dos i vinga, anem.
Gràcies, Javier. Després d'aquestes paraules és una mica difícil de continuar perquè sembla que no és per tant la nostra vida per allà a Finlàndia i del nostre sistema educatiu. Jo crec que aquestes jornades han sigut molt, molt interessants per nosaltres també, per aprendre coses noves. Jo per començar m'agradaria fer una mica reflexió de les reflexions de Miquel i Enric. El que passa és que si començo a fer masses reflexions llavors perdem el que estem ara, que és per escoltar aviat a Quimmo com és la formació de mestres i especialment a la formació a l'escola de pràctiques. El que sí que volia dir de l'anterior representació que, i el que veu aviat és el cas de la Universitat de Helsinki, Universitat i l'Escola de Pràctiques de Helsinki, i sí, varien una mica les pràctiques entre universitats. Si miro en internet, per exemple, la Universitat de Jyväskylä té mínimament diferent els punts, els crèdits i quan els fan, etc. I des de l'última fila, si he vist bé, és per això que explica aquest rombo de color fosc que hi havia abans a la representació. Llavors això que també l'avaluació, la inspecció de les escoles, ja Jari aquest matí ja va dir-ho clarament, que inspecció escolar no n'hi ha, però com deia Jari al matí, sí que hi ha inspecció dintre de les escoles, o sigui, nosaltres els directors sí que ho fem bastant i fem les charles amb els professors i mestres i també naturalment entrem a les aules, fem l'avaluació, com desenvolupen les classes i certes alumnes i també per el treball d'equip psicopedagògic que és el director d'escola que és responsable d'aquest equip. Bé, després de la representació de Quimmo, voldria dir unes quantes coses, com es formen a les escoles, la formació continuada, com està organitzat dintre les escoles, i també, si hi ha temps, volia explicar breument com es trien personal a les escoles que hi ha renovacions, que al nostre municipi, per exemple, just ara estem empleant aquest nou formulari. I també, si hi ha interès, podria explicar com es pot ser, arribar a ser un director d'escola. Y estas representaciones los tengo, el otro al menos lo tengo en castellano, y solamente para molestar un poco a Xavi, igual me cambio a castellano, ¿no?
Pues ya os he dicho que parlo muchas lenguas.
No, el único es que para escribir mejor castellano para mí, por eso los he hecho en castellano. Pero ahora, sin más palabras, paso a keyword to Kimmo, and I might explain something with Kimmo also. Okay.
Thank you, Pekka, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Do I need this? Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you, Pekka, for that. I'm doing my job in English, and when I can't do it in English, so Pekka will help with Catalonian. Okay. It's an honor to stop the evening by telling about Finland and Finnish system, and we started it with Jari in the morning. So the special in the Finnish teacher education, I think, is the teacher training schools, and that's what I'm going to tell you about, and then a little bit the practice we have in the teacher training schools, and in the end I'm going to tell about the teacher training schools in the whole country. What is the issue? What are we going to do? What we have to do? But first, some things about the University of Helsinki, because I want to say that the teacher training schools are a part of the universities. The lecturers, the teachers who are teaching in the teacher training schools are lecturers of the university. For instance, Viikki Teacher Training School, every teacher is a lecturer in the university. And as Jari told you, we have in University of Helsinki the Faculty of Behavioral Sciences, and inside there is the Institute of Behavioral Sciences. And there is the Department of Teacher Education, and in the Department of Teacher Education cooperate with two teacher training schools, which are Viikki teacher training schools. There we have grades from 1 to 9, and then the upper secondary school. And then called Helsingin Normaalilyseo, and there is only grades from 7 to 8, the basic education, and then the upper secondary school. Okay. In the Department of Teacher Education, studies can be carried out in 6 different sections. That's what Jari in the morning mentioned to you. Subject teacher, special education, home economics, craft science, class teacher education, and the kindergarten education. And here is the Finnish education system. As for the fact, you can see the kindergarten teacher for the pre- and primary education, class teachers, to the basic education from grades to 1 to 6, and then the subject teachers from the 7th grade to the upper secondary. And now we can watch a little, if it's going to work, a good videotape from the Finnish education. It takes a few minutes. These pictures are from our school, from the Viikki teacher training school.
According to PISA studies, Finnish students have ranked very high in science, math, and reading. Finland is the best achieving European country in all these three domains. In reading and science, we have always scored among the top three countries. The classroom climate in Finland is very exceptional. We have more noise in our classrooms than, for example, in the Asian countries, in Japan or in China. In this figure, we can see that Japan has very quiet classrooms. And Finland is here on the bottom, meaning that we have a lot of noise. This can be explained by the nature of our classrooms. We have a democratic classroom climate and we are getting good learning results in Finland. The goal of teacher education is to educate pedagogically thinking teachers who can reflect on their own work and who can see their role in the Finnish society. We educate ethical professionals who contribute to the holistic development of their students. In Finland, we can select our teachers from a very motivated and well-achieving student population. This is a big difference compared to some other countries, for example, to the United States. If you look at the admission rates at the University of Helsinki during the last 10 years, we can see that it has been more difficult to get into the class teacher education than to the faculties of law or medicine. The admission rate to class teacher education has been around 5 to 7%, when in law it has been around 12 to 17%, and in medicine 11 to 20%. In addition to academic achievement, we look at some other qualities from our teachers. We look at social skills, communication skills, and also how the teachers see their own profession. Teaching at the Department of Teacher Education is research-based. This means that we teach what we research, and we research what we teach. After master's degree in education, our teachers have the skills to continue in the doctoral program. Even though our teachers graduate with master's degree and we educate them for lifelong learning, they need support, they need in-service training. For example, teachers need to update their knowledge and their skills, how to use modern information technology in classroom and how to promote student learning with the help of new technologies.
So where is my... there. Okay, and some facts about what you have to study quickly. A substitute teacher, there is the things that Jari mentioned this morning and the bottom class teacher have to be a master of education sciences. And there is the facts you have to be, if you want to be a qualified teacher in Finland, the substitute teacher or the class teacher. 300 credits for both. And now to the point that's what my work, the teaching practice. The substitute teacher, from those 300 credits, they have 20 credits as teaching practice. And for most of the students, they do that 60 credits as the pedagogical studies. They do it during 1 year. So in October, there is 7 credits teaching practice. It takes 8 weeks, and they have 15 lessons, which in the lower grades is 45 minutes, and in from the grades from 7 to 9, it's 75 minutes. And there had been in January, 3-week teaching practice, but nowadays it has changed. I'm not sure what is it nowadays. Is it
zero?
Yes. There is no that's not that's that teaching practice. And then in March, now beginning when I'm going back to Helsinki, is the big one, 9 credits, which takes 9 weeks. And then in class teacher education, they have 20 credits of that 300. And in the first year, they have the first one. They come to our school in the fourth period. We have 4 periods in university in March. And that's 3 credits. They stay 3 weeks there, and they have 18 lessons. And then in third year, they have that 9 credits where they have 60 lessons. And then the last one, which they have in fourth or fifth year, it that main subject teaching practice. And nowadays, because we have so many students in the class teacher education, our school cannot take them. So we have the field school system. We have 10 field schools in the Helsinki area where they go. Then they are closer to their next, when they are going to have their teacher working. Well, here is some facts about the training practices in Helsinki. The target of the practices is to develop and deepen the professional growth of the student. This is which Jari has told you this morning. During the practice, theory and practice interact. The matters the student has learned during the pedagogic studies and the subject education will be applied in the class, and on the other hand, the practice will be conceptualized. There is that. The student is supervised so that she will become aware of his or her own educational theory through cooperation and individual methods. That's the point that each of the students has their thinking about their teaching. And what are we doing are going to take it as he or she knows what I'm going to do, what's the best in my teacher thinking. The practices are supervised and instructors, and the aim is to gradually increase the independence of the students. When we go to the fifth year, the supervisors are not so much saying do this or do that or something like that.
Yes, I just wanted to mention that, it has been said earlier already, but those bases they have in teacher training and also in practice, in those practices, later on in normal schools, we really trust a lot about the teachers. So in a way, we sort of count as it has been so difficult to get into the university, and they are very selected students, and we in normal schools, we see the training good training. So in a way, we assume that the product is good for us.
Yes, and the main point in the teacher education, for instance, is a cooperation. We teach them how to cooperate. So when after the 5-year studies, they go to the, for instance, for the Becca's school, they are able to ask help or cooperate with the older teachers. So talking about the 2 or 3 first years working as a teacher are very hard for many teachers. That's why we are learning them to cooperate, and so they can discuss and ask help when they go to the field school. And now to the training practice in the teacher training school. What we do there? All the practices include observing the lessons, group meetings, seminars, lectures, discussions with the supervisor, etc., etc. And now I take one of those. I showed you six of those different teacher practicing models. Here is the minor subject teaching practice in class teacher education. It means that it's a teacher practice where the becoming teacher, class teacher, is practicing the subject didactics, how to teach different subjects at the school. And it takes 9 credits. And here is the aims for that, which you can read. So you see, all the teaching practices, there are very different targets to hold it. And then, practically, what happens in a class? In the beginning of the practice period, the class team, where is the class lecturer, the class teacher, and the student, plans the teaching and makes written long-term plans for the whole period in each teaching subject. In the calendar weeks, they are staying there in the one same classroom for 6 weeks, and they are planning the whole 6 weeks with the classroom teacher. And when they have those 60 lessons, for each lesson, they have to have an individual plan, written plan for the lesson. So when I have the first meeting with the becoming class teachers, I always say them, welcome to the academic class teacher practicing, because making 60 of those written plans, they say after 2 weeks, what is this? Welcome to the academic world, I say. And plans are made in cooperation with the class teacher and the university teacher of subject didactics. In the class teacher education, the university lecturers come to our school and help and observe the lessons. They don't. We have this practice in period 1, 2, and 3 because we have 10 different subjects at school. It's not possible to rehearsal all those subjects. So they have 5 subjects in each period. And that's what they do, a personal training plan. In the beginning of the practice period, the student will compose a personal training plan. And that's compulsory. And they write all the time. When the practice starts, they start to write and reflect with their tutors, and they write. And after the practice is over, after 6 weeks, they give the whole package to the tutors so they can read it, what they have done. And now you can ask about the practices if there's some questions, but now I want to tell a little bit more about these special teacher training schools, because I think they are special in the Europe and in the whole world. I think in some countries there is schools like this. And here is all the teacher training schools which we have in Finland. As I mentioned, in Helsinki 2, in Turku 2, Tampere 1, Jyväskylä, Joensuu 2, Oulu, and then in Lapland. And in English, it's we are called, the network is called Finnish Teacher Training Schools.
Sorry, Kimmo, before you go to this, I want to ask. Yesterday I had the opportunity to be with Javier in Vic, and we had a quite long, nice talk there. And there came some questions that I wanted to ask. Someone asked yesterday that as your training school is sort of a normal school, because they are situated in a sort of normal areas, and students are from that areas. You've got many teachers, class teachers and secondary teachers, school teachers, and then you have a lot of training activity there. Lots of students, lots of teachers from university. So don't they get disturbed, the students, with all the movement going around all the time?
I think as we are a normal school, we have every kind of pupils there. Pupils, those who are not so good, and so those in the special needs, I think for those pupils that's not good. But in the other hand, we have the student teachers. 85% of the year there is student teachers. So the class teacher, the class lecturer, have all the time three adults with the whole group, and that's the positive thought about that. Then we have a lot of visitors, and I think when the pupils come to the first grade, they get used to that there is many teachers all the time, and there is students who are doing research. They are videotaping or something like that. There is many adults and in the classroom in the same time, they get used to it. And when they are in the second grade, there is 45 Japanese men going around, and they are just learning. They get used to it.
Other little thing, there's this teacher training sessions or weeks. Between those weeks, the students sometimes they also come to the your training school, don't they?
Yes, all the time, because we are cooperating with the faculty all the time. So, for instance, in class teacher education, they have a course, didactics course. It's called didactics, and it's about five credits. Where first they have some seminars with the lecturer in the faculty, and then they have tasks. Niin. Task about didactics. Then they come to our school and they observe, and then they go back to the faculty, and then they discuss about what they have seen all the time in different courses. We are doing cooperation with the faculty. Okay, then a few words about these amazing teacher training schools in Finland. The Ministry of Education and Science in Finland, they say what we have to do in those training schools, and here you see those. The first provision is the provision of teaching. We have normal kids, and they are not chosen, they are coming in the area. Our multicultural percent is about 10 for the different coming from different lands pupils. Then the second is the supervision of tutoring of student teaching. That's our second duty. And then teaching experiments and research. And we have cooperate with our behavioral science faculty, then with the psychology faculty, and so on, in different places from the university. And then the profession of in-service education. when the teachers are in the field, we have to learn them more about teaching. And now, for the in-service education, I take one example, what is a big one we are doing just now with the FTT, Finnish Teacher Training Schools, is the curriculum design for 2016. In Finland, in April 2016, we are going to have a new, whole new curriculum in every school. And we are going to, we have started this in 2013 to design this process. A curriculum design is a super program for curriculum design process, as I said, and it has begun in autumn and it's going on, and that's a good figure.
Yes, I interrupt. There's this new curriculum. The earlier one is from 2004, so it has been every 10 to 12, 13 years that we renew our curriculum. And our connection from the normal school and normal municipalities has been very strong now to this e-Norsi, and from the name you of course understand it, it's a internet-based support. A lot of that is internet-based support. There are platforms for discussion, there are different kind of support that is given. And we in municipalities, we had the good opportunity to comment the minister level plans until end of 2013. In each municipalities we had groups of commentators. I was also in one group. And after that, the bases were sort of thought and written, and they were ready in end of 2014. And just now in the municipalities, we are now doing the municipality level curriculum, which means that we start from the national curriculum, and we think we sort of concrete certain things. We have groups working in, for example, multicultural matters, which is actually my group in our municipality, or we have a group thinking about the cooperation between school and homes. We have a group of which thinks about the municipal matters in special education, etc. And of course, then we have sort of mathematical subjects, languages, and the sort of traditional secondary school subjects also present. But the most important things are these general municipal activities and matters. I wanted to interrupt because this is really something that we use a lot in municipalities, this e-Norsi.
Yes, and as you see, in Finland, each school is doing its own curriculum. And what we are doing, we are just advising how to do it, and what's the main things you have to consider. And we are talking about this guidance. As you see, the National Board of Education gives the main facts, and then here is the e-Norsi, Finnish Teacher Training School network, which helps with the regional state agency. And then the knowledge goes to each school everywhere in Finland. Here is some facts. But here you can see the teacher training schools once again on the map of Finland. And that's what I just explained to you and Pekka said. Mm. more information there. Have you, Pekka, something to give more? Or are we going to the questions?
Well, yes, I think maybe if you have questions, and meanwhile I try to find some new, more slides.
Questions?
No dirigeixo mal. Massa. Abans m'han comentat els companys finlandesos que les taules que ells fan, el moderador parla poquíssim. Així que intentaré una mica ser finlandès, no? Que ho facin ells. Bé. Respecte amb ells. Preguntes. Hi ha alguna pregunta que vulguin fer, senyor Freixer? One moment, they need the micro.
I wanted to ask if you could say some more about what happens during those critical 6 weeks of when the students are in the classroom with a teacher jointly planning the lessons, because I think there's much to be learned from that.
Okay. Yes. I'm not sure. I don't get. Yeah. Okay. I take it practically. When the third year student comes, there is 100 students, and we have 18 classrooms. 18, three grade one, three grade two classrooms. So it takes 18 classroom. And then we take two students to one classroom. They are cooperating together. So we have all the time three adults there, that's why. And then they come for the six weeks. The first week, they are just making, observing and so, and cooperating and doing plans for the five-week direction when they have those 60 lessons to have. Yeah.
Més preguntes? Aquí dalt jo no veig res. Aquí aquesta senyora.
Just to add on to that question, during the 6 weeks that they're in the school and that first week when they're doing all the planning with the teacher and they write their lesson plans, etc., for the subject, when is that planning done? Is that done after the class hours? Is that done in the evening, on the weekends? Or
Yeah. They are doing it. They have those 60 lessons means that they have 10 lessons during the week. So they have plenty of time to have those two plans and write it down.
And do you provide them with a template, a lesson plan template that is characteristic of each school, or is that one that the national the template, the lesson plan, that is that something that is characteristic to that teacher in that school, or is that something that is standardized across the in the university, or who develops that lesson plan?
The main who look at it is the class lecturer in the class, the teacher. But then they have those lecturers from the faculty. They are the subject didactics. They watch them that they are okay.
Yeah. I want to add a little bit. When there are many things have changed in teacher practice in practice school. We started actually with Kimmo same year 81 in the same university, and from those years many things have changed, but this planning thing continues more or less in the same way. And sometimes as a student I remember we thought that, well, I don't know if it's so worth to not so much worth planning so exactly detailed But later on, when you were a teacher, you sort of noticed that it was a very good thing. In a way, at least people like myself, I want to improvise more, and I wanted to improvise more than. But to do that sort of strict plan was very good for me also.
Yes, and about the timetable, the students should have so that during the 6 week they have no other studies; they have only the teaching practice in the teacher training school.
Understand? Està contestat? Sí? Pues, Eduard, i crec que per aquí darrere hi ha hagut alguna persona que ha aixecat la mà, no? No? Bueno, pues Eduard.
Yeah, in one of the slides you were showing that the tasks of the training schools, one of them was to develop a new experience or pedagogical experience, something like this. I was wondering if this is related with innovation and detecting new learning procedures that are successful. For instance, how to improve learnings of maths, how to improve learning of music, how to improve, and then how you work with the university for successful results to get spread into the system.
Oh. It's hard to explain in English. Siis ymmärrän mä oikein, että tota niin, niin
mä en miten me kysymys oikein, mutta
niin mä käyn, mutta niin. miten sä ymmärsit sen? Niin?
En mä kuunnellut sitä oikein. tota, onko se se innovaatio ja muuta?
Can you do the question in Catalonian? So,
Suposo que li deixo a contestar a ell, no? Jo, ja com que està aquí. Niin, eli tota, tavallaan nyt kun ne opiskelijat tota, siellä odotetaan sitä innovatiivisuutta ja muuta, niin siellä niin kuin testaillaan sitä uusia opetusmenetelmiä ja haetaan niin kuin uutta myös siihen opetukseen niin kuin isommalla tasolla tavallaan, että et tavallaan se didaktikot ja muut on siellä mukana sen takia, että se, tota, saadaan sitä uutta opetukseen myös, että onko siellä semmoista funktiota harjoittelukoululla, sitä hän hakee. Kyllä mä näkisin ainakin, että ne on. Ne,
Yes, if I get the question now, right, I think what's the point? What we are trying to do is to encourage the students to try different things, new things, not to make so do this like I say, but we are together doing different experiments and so we are cooperating like three adults who are very interested in teaching, not that there's one supervisor who watch out what are you doing wrong or what you are doing not so wrong. That's I think is the climate in our practice teaching practices. Yeah, I think in the whole studies during the 300 credits, they all the time they are discussing about these things. But if you mean that 20 credit teaching practice, we have their seminars where more and more students and more tutors come together and discuss about these things. For instance, in mathematics didactics, there is nowadays so that they videotape every lesson they have, and then they go together to a place and watch those, and they are arguing and saying what's good and what's bad, and so discussing.
When we did this training, final training with Kimmo, it was 85 or 86. That time, that was done in a training school, and it was qualified from 1 to 5. It was a very hard training, three and a half month training. We did only that, planned very carefully everything. And it was very important because if you got 4 or 5, you could be a teacher in a training school, or it helped you a lot later on if you wanted to be a headmaster. Mm-hmm. And it was very important the number you get. But all this has changed completely, haven't it?
Yes, it was, am I right, it was 94. It was the last time we get those ranking lists. After that, 20 years, 15 years, no. 20 years, no more. It's a process, it's not.
And the training is not done in your school anymore? Or is it done completely?
That last one, no. Because I just told you, the last one, they go to the field schools in the network, to the normal schools.
More questions?
Hem sabut per al Xavier que vostè és, a més, en aquests moments un director d'escola. És correcte. Mm. Va, més enllà de tots els continguts disciplinars que ensenyen els estudiants, jo no sóc un expert en això, però sospitem que una de les coses que influeix en el procés d'aprenentatge és la predisposició social de l'entorn de recolzament a l'educació, a les famílies, la importància que les famílies donen a l'educació, etc. Per tant, com que tenim la fortuna de que vostè ha estat aquí i allà, si ens pogués parlar una mica del que aquí, a Catalunya i allà, a Finlàndia, l'actitud, l'acompanyament, la valorització social que les famílies donen a l'aprenentatge de la canalla. Gràcies.
Bé, jo crec que el que aquí un dels problemes que trobeu vosaltres és que aquí el número d'alumnes per aula, en primer lloc, és molt més elevat. Em sembla que es van pujar i tot l'any passat. Nosaltres considerem que 25 és el màxim de l'aula. A vegades hi ha més, però si hi ha més de 25 alumnes, llavors normalment es pot demanar suport estatal per grups grans. En el nostre cas, municipi de 40.000 habitants, em sembla que vam demanar diners per 15 grups. Llavors, això és una cosa que clar, impedeix una mica l'ensenyança individualitzada si el grup de treball és massa gran. Això és bastant evident. Llavors, el que passa és que jo crec que aquí el que vosaltres, no a tot arreu, però a moltes escoles i moltes zones, com que aquí hi ha molta diversitat entre zones i entre escoles, jo crec que hi ha escoles realment molt bones, hi ha àrees on és molt difícil d'exercir docència, i en el ratio és molt ample. Llavors, jo crec que aquí hi ha moltes escoles que els mestres i professors han de fer una mica massa tasca dels pares, coses que haurien de venir ja des de la família, convivència, i això és una, clar, aquest temps que passes fas amb això, llavors és de fora d'algun altre lloc. Llavors nosaltres això ho tenim una miqueta millor, no a tot arreu. El nostre municipi, per exemple, estic parlant d'això perquè ho conec més, la nostra escola està en una zona on hi ha més problemes a tot el municipi. Nosaltres, si hi ha tres factors que compleixen el nivell d'atur dels pares, a Finlàndia si és 8 o 9%, al nostre barri és quasi 30% ara. Número d'immigrants, Finlàndia és molt més baix que aquí,
Però al nostre barri, per exemple, el número d'immigrants és bastant elevat. 35 alumnes de 240 són immigrants. Ja ho sé que és baix comparat a algunes escoles per Catalunya. Però, en tot cas, nivell d'atur, número d'immigrants i també el nivell d'estudis dels pares, nivell socioeconòmic dels pares. Aquests tres factors han trobat que influeixen clarament en el desenvolupament de l'alumne i les possibilitats de l'alumne. Llavors, si compleixen aquests tres requisits, com el cas de la nostra escola, un altre cop pots demanar una ajuda específic de municipi. És una cosa que s'ha de fer anualment, però és una progressia molt, molt simple. I llavors, amb això, si ja parlo amb números concretes, reps 110.000 euros extras a l'any. I amb aquest diners, nosaltres, com directors d'escola, podem planificar conjuntament amb el Consell Escolar Municipal quines coses volem gastar aquests diners. En el nostre cas, per exemple, van contratar dues treballadores socials extras, ja tenim una, però dues extras dintre de l'escola. Es diuen ajuda familiar, però ajuda familiar dintre de l'escola. Llavors, allà mateix a l'escola, entre les classes, van preguntant certs alumnes si han fet les deures o si tenen avui el futbol o la música, i ajuden per les tardes també, els fan activitats. Llavors, aquesta almenys és un tema jo crec que és important, que allà s'intenta, diguéssim, el que no té tanta possibilitat, intenta ajudar bastant. Per l'altra banda, jo crec que si ara critico la nostra escola finesa, que a vegades jo tinc almenys sensació que oblidem una mica els que podrien rendir molt més. O sigui, es concentra potser inclús massa amb els que necessiten molta ajuda. Llavors, jo tinc la sensació que aquí hi ha escoles que realment els alumnes rendeixen molt bé, però no sé, igual no és així. Bé, jo el que, no sé si ja vaig per un altre tema, però vol dir que el que realment està molt bé aquí a Catalunya, i jo no sóc de política ni vol ser, però he de dir que això de que sabeu més d'una llengua, sabeu raonar amb dos o més llengües, és realment molt important. Nosaltres també tenim dues llengües oficials, finlandès i suec, i jo crec que és una riquesa important. En el nostre cas, el govern, diguéssim, sempre ha apostat que les dues llengües són obligatòries a tot el país. Encara que la minoria sueca és 4,5% o 5%, hi ha moltes zones on no es parla en suec, però en tot cas és obligatori. I això ha conservat la llengua i cultura de parla suec. I jo crec que a Europa s'ha de tenir molt, molt en compte aquest fet, perquè hi ha llengües que dominen fàcilment altres. I he de dir una cosa, que l'Auli, que estava aquí fa 25 anys, era l'última vegada que vaig parlar amb Auli, que ara ja s'ha marxat a Madrid, i amb Auli vam parlar mentre es menjaven, que has fixat, Pekka, que bé que la gent avui en dia parla anglès. Jo vaig comentar, pensar que sí que parlen molt bé. En 25 anys, una millora general, per vosaltres i en general. Les dues tenim aquesta idea. O sigui que les coses de l'educació van a poc, però sí que hi ha canvis, sí que hi ha millores, i aquesta ja estic extenint a unes coses que no era la pregunta.
Sí, en primer lloc, gràcies per l'exposició. Jo voldria fer dues preguntes, una a nivell d'organització de les pràctiques i l'altra a nivell de garantia de la qualitat del professorat que està a les aules, dels mestres. En relació a l'organització de les pràctiques, m'ha semblat entendre que entraven dos alumnes per aula. No sé si això és habitual o és només en algun tipus de període de pràctiques. I després també si l'escola de pràctiques, que en els tres períodes és la mateixa, o és convenient que, o teniu que cada vegada sigui diferent. per seguir projectes o perquè la formació sigui el màxim d'àmplia possible. I llavors, referent a la garantia de qualitat del professorat, m'ha semblat entendre, dels mestres de l'aula, perdó, m'ha semblat entendre que el professor Tuconen deia que els professors en exercici, els mestres en exercici, eren observats a l'aula. Llavors, si això també és una pràctica habitual com a inspecció, entre cometes, que ja sé que allà no hi ha la inspecció i que suposo que la formació dels mestres ja fa que gairebé no hagin d'estar inspeccionats, però si aquesta observació ja és habitual i si un professor que vulgui ser observat de manera voluntària per millorar també la seva qualitat és possible. I en relació amb això, si s'han trobat alguna vegada en algun cas d'algun professor observat que la seva pràctica docent no sigui l'adequada i en aquest cas què és el que es fa amb aquest professor, amb aquest mestre que està en exercici, perquè en definitiva també serà mestre de pràctiques. Tampoc sé si els mestres de pràctiques ho poden ser tots o també són seleccionats pels centres. Perdó per les preguntes, però gràcies.
Eren tres, no? Les preguntes i com pensen com màxim una cosa a vegades dues, però anem per pautes. Ens han quedat tot, onse cocs per luoc, onse normal en ese tot.
Jo.
Yes. Sí, yeah. Eso de dos per aula és el habitual.
Yeah.
Llavors, vaig per l'última perquè el segon ja he oblidat, però el tota mitä sitten tää että eks ne opettaa sitten koe, että kun niitä tarkkaillaan tavallaan, että käydään siellä, että ne tota se on semmoista niin kuin sisäistä arviointia. Et mä en oikein nyt ymmärtänyt tätä kysymystä.
Mä käyn.
A ver, la segunda pregunta, usted podría repetirlo porque no ha quedat clar.
Respecte a l'organització de les pràctiques era, primer, si sempre era habitual que entraven dos alumnes per pràctica de paraula,
sí, això,
i després l'altre sí. Era si eren sempre les mateixes escoles.
Yeah. Mm. Sí.
O sigui, els tres períodes de pràctiques, yes. L'alumne fa les pràctiques a la mateixa escola.
Yes. Sí.
Yeah. They are going in the first year and the third year to the Wiki Teacher Training School. Mm-hmm. And after that, they have the third period of teacher practice. They are going to the one of, what I think, let's say, 10 or 12 field schools. They can choose there. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then...
I la tercera era també per l'escola de pràctica.
No, si els mestres de pràctiques eren seleccionats o podien ser tots, o l'escola decidia qui podia ser mestre formador de pràctiques.
Ni també tens de tot si té opetat valikoitu sinne.
Yes. Of course they have to be we have the selection very they have to have studies. For instance, last spring we have one free teacher, we have to select one teacher for our school, and there were 25 candidates, and of the 25 candidates, 7 was doctors. So we select very high specialized teachers, and very often the teacher from our school is going to faculty to research or teach or doing something, so there is a free place and we can take a candidate for 1 year and then she or he is going to be there for a year, and if there's going to be a free place, then that means that you can learn the tutoring only by doing it. Doing after year, and then that's why it's very important that they have high-level studies, but also you have to do that tutoring in a very good way. That I think are things.
Okay. Yes.
Yes,
we always have at least in the municipal schools we have all 6 month period. First 6 month is very easy to sort of stop the contract.
No, I think that she was asking precisely if this happens.
Well, it happens every now and then, not very often, but we have to do it sometimes. But usually before that, we have a... Normalment no passa, però sí pot passar, i normalment es fa una crida oral, diguéssim, si ha passat alguna... Hi ha coses que, naturalment, si passa, per exemple, l'abús sexual o clares evidències d'això, o que venen trugats o beguts els mestres o professors a l'escola, és un despedit immediat. Si és una cosa més complicat, normalment s'estudia més, i si hi ha evidència clara es fa una crida oral, diguéssim. Normalment, com directors d'escola, donem l'oral també escrit, perquè vegi, estem d'acord que en tal i tal dia hem estat parlant d'aquest tema. S'intenta donar un suport per al mestre, s'intenta donar ajuda psicològica també, municipis tenen ajuda d'aquest tipus organitzat. Llavors, però si continua, ara estaria parlant coses molt desagradables, però a vegades passa que llavors pot ser que el pròxim pas, si continua, per exemple, crida contínuament als alumnes o diu paraulotes o alguna cosa així, un avís escrit. Però si continua, un altre avís escrit, i després de dos avís escrits es pot despedir amb un temps, em sembla que és dos mesos, després de dos mesos es pot fer-lo. Abans que olvido, I want to show you something about this continuous, this inorcy thing. I think it was quite clear, very important to our normal schools. And we have continuous education connected to university. Palmenia in southern Finland, connected with Helsinki University. I mentioned that yesterday there in Vic. Some of you were there, I noticed. And this is very important to us also. We as headmasters, principals, we sort of stick to our municipal training plan. We try to focus one or two or three years to certain subjects. As once again talking about our municipality, we now focus on ICT skills. We focus on gymnastics and movement and activities, activate students in mathematics, in all subjects. And of course, also in the breaks, to do more activities in the schools. And the third thing we are concentrating is in this difficult question, integration of special students in normal classes. So we stick to those basic municipal plan, and all the planning, all the training in particular school must be in line with that municipal training plan. And then sometimes we have municipalities together, some interesting important matter. This photo is from two weeks ago. We had in our school a training for those teachers who give extra Finnish lessons to immigrant students in seven different municipalities. And they gathered Wednesday afternoon, a couple of hours. We had specialists from Turku University, and it was a very important thing for those teachers, and we will have a continuous training for that. So sometimes we have this together with the different municipalities, we together train teachers. And then we have a little bit of possibility to our school own training. For example, in our school, there's now a lot of interest to this drama teaching and drama in English and drama in whatever. And I've sort of given green light to that. So I think it's important. And then we have also, according to the accordance with the trade union, we have a very strong and important teacher trade union. So we have sort of a 3-day year rule. So we have training
usually half of that is training about these municipal matters, about the for example, ICT knowledge this year will be. And then we have 3 hours a week for teachers, for meetings, for training, for contact with parents also. Most teachers say that this 3 hours is far too less, and I think it's true. But anyway, if you teach 25 sessions, for example, per week, it's counted 25 times 1.5, so it is 38 hours plus these 3 hours. This is sort of the we usually count in the school. So we think that if you give one session to prepare that and to prepare the exams and correct the exams, you need 1.5 hour of work for one session. So, and then sometimes we have to say to the teachers also that as in the contract it's written clearly that all teachers should train themselves on their own. And then what is maybe different from some other countries, many trainings are organized during the working hours. And I think that's it for a moment.
Per mi avui és un dia molt especial perquè fa 10 anys que jo vaig llegir la meva tesi ara, precisament a Blanquerna, sobre el sistema educatiu finlandès, i m'ha costat 10 anys que poguéssiu arribar a veure i a sentir-los a ells, no? Perquè l'important és que sentiu aquestes persones i que puguem generar algun tipus de vinculació, evidentment, amb ells. Estic segur, estan aquí tots ells, perquè tenen ganes d'aquesta vinculació. I ara ens toca a nosaltres veure com ho gestionem, no? Així és que, primer, Yari, gràcies per la teva... Yari, gràcies per tu presència, la teva presència, i a vosaltres, Quimo, també, i Pekka, vale, per la vostra, jo diria, interessant aportació, no? I, bueno, esperem que puguem anar aprofundint més. Com us dic jo, ells tenen ganes, ara és cosa nostra, també, de veure com ho gestionem. I ho deixem aquí, no, Miquel? Sí? Gràcies.